Welcome back. In part 1, we laid the groundwork by creating the base of our app with Bolt. Now in part 2, we're moving into more powerful tools. But don't worry, Cline in particular won't feel intimidating. For non-technical developers, it has a similar feel to Bolt but with extra capabilities, like automatically testing the app by opening the browser on its own. Alongside Cline, we'll use Cursor IDE for even deeper customization, bringing us closer to a polished app. Let's dive in. Let me go to Cursor and run npm install to make sure all the dependencies are there. So now let us run npm run dev. Let's check if it is working locally. Yes. Now I'm going to download our GitHub tutorial outline from ChatGPT, and then I will create a new file in our Git repository in Cursor and go to Claude to download the UI flow diagram and put it in our Git repository in Cursor. So I would like to view this UI flow diagram and show it to you. This is going to be the basis of the AI development. So I will preview it using an open source mermaid diagram viewer that I have created earlier. I will simply copy the contents of the mermaid diagram code and I will go to the mermaid diagram viewer here and I will create a new diagram. I will name it user flow. And then I will click on show code, paste the code in, click preview, and click full screen. So this is the user flow diagram that Claude had created for us. So this will be the foundation of how the entire project will be developed by our AI dev tools. Let me go back to Cursor and let me commit all of these changes. Okay, so we're still reviewing our GitHub app here and it's still not usable, although all the components has been there already. But we will ask Cursor just to be sure. So if we go back to bolt.new here, it says that all the components has been created with proper interfaces, props, and functionality. So we will just repeat this same prompt, but we will use Cursor. Let's find the chat for Cursor. Open chat, and then I will open this specs. Then I will ask same prompt, and then I will control enter so that all the code base will be referenced. So now it's reading the files just to be sure. Okay, so it looks like it found some missing components here, like the layout, tutorial container, navigation bar. So there are many other components that are missing. I'm not sure why. Let's verify it. It's here. Looks like Cursor is not the best tool for this, so I will simply close this one and I will choose to work with Cline this time. So I will go to Cline and then I will ask the same message or prompt. Then I will mention the specs. So you see, we cannot just say Cursor is better, Bolt is better, or Cline is better. We have to test it ourselves. I will start a new task again. I will mention the different spec this time, the flow. So I will ask Cline to... It's reading the files one by one. What's the final verdict here? The flow diagram reveals several implementation gaps that needs to be addressed. I will start a new task and then I will mention it again. But this time, I will also mention the outline tutorial. So now the landing page is being created. All right, so please install the missing package. If you observe this usage counter here, you will soon realize that even though Cline is effective, it's a bit costly compared to the other dev tool that we're going to use, which is Aider. But each of these tools has their own strengths and weaknesses. I actually like Cline's way of editing things because I know what's changed. So you can see here it's created a new file, although it's the same as with Bolt. But the difference is if Cline decided to update the file like this one, you can see the changes here. But this is still not effective because it's actually rewriting everything. And soon I will show you how Aider do things differently. For the overall project structure, we use Bolt. And for this wiring up of components, we are using Cline. Cline. I attempted to use Cursor earlier, but I'm not satisfied with its performance. I might use it again for other things, especially if we're coding by hand. A Cursor then will show its power. Alright, finally, hopefully this is the last component because I'm getting worried about I might soon hit the daily rate limit. We can see Cline's power here. Now it's done. Let's review the report. Entry flow, core tutorial components, state management. Okay, so let's run it. npm run dev. Looks like we have a lot of issues here that's not captured within this terminal window. Let me refresh. So here's what I'm going to do. Here's another advantage of Cline. I will exit this npm run dev and then I will start a new task and then I will ask it to please fix the console errors when running npm run dev. You have see it for yourself. I will show you what I mean by that, because if we simply run npm run dev here, Cline cannot see this. Now it's going to ask to execute this command and then I will click proceed while running. There you go. This is what I mean by when I said see it for yourself. So Cline has the ability to use the browser and actually see the console logs. But notice the cost increase here because of this usage. This cost a bit more than usual text-based prompts or chats. Cline actually is using the latest computer use API by Anthropic. So it sees several type errors as we can see here and now it's fixing those errors. For non-developer viewers out there, if you want to continue without Bolt after you have established your project in Bolt, I suggest you go straight to Cline because of its ability to fix issues effectively. And then there you go. Cline was able to fix the issues. Now it's trying to check and verify if there are errors. So to save cost, I will simply ignore this and then I will ask Cline a different task. I will ask Cline to implement the outline. I will create a new task instead. But before that, let me commit all of these changes made by Cline. Okay, I will commit and I will sync these changes to GitHub. I will create a new task and then I will mention the outline and then I will say, okay, nice. It's creating the tutorial content JSON file. All right, let's save. So it only created the first part of the tutorial content. Now it's creating the second part, which is the advanced content. It's a wise decision to do this way because it's going to be problematic if we create a large file larger than 300 lines of code. In my experience, if the file reaches around 300 or more than 300 lines of code, it's getting tricky for LLMs to process and they tend to deviate from the task being requested. So it created three parts of JSON file, but the problem is it only created those JSON files. It didn't actually wire this up to the components. Let me just commit those and then I will ask Cline to wire those up mentioning all of this. I'm not sure if Cline will be able to see the content now. Yep, it cannot see this new file, so I will have to restart Cursor. Let me start with the tutorial content. Please wire this tutorial content to the components. So the tutorial context actually has some dummy data. Now we're using the actual data from our outline. Cline might request to run this, but I will decline because it's going to bump up our cost. If we do this manually and verify in the browser that there's no issue, then there's no reason to ask Cline to proceed. So that's why I'm manually running it this way. All right, let's see. Let's start by understanding, okay, what is Git? Okay, key terms. Next section. All right, it's working. Does it have any issues in the console? Nothing. Nice. This is GitHub for beginners interactive tutorial. So the progress is still not updated. The lessons also in the progress. So let's see how far we can build this, but I will not show everything to you here in order to save some time. So I will create another task here, but this time I will ask it to wire up the next content. So if we go here, the advanced content. Let me first commit our changes so far. And you can see if we're using GitHub, we can see what's changed and we can always review what's changed and or revert it back. You can't do that in Bolt. If we revert in Bolt, it will revert everything, but in Git you can choose to revert any part of the code that was changed. So that's the advantage. That's a huge advantage. Let's go back to Cline and then let's copy this prompt, change it a bit. Okay, it's verifying some of the other components that might need updates. I really like this type of checking done by Cline. It makes me feel confident about the code it's updating. I hope it didn't override something good here. That risk is still there. So I have low balance now. So let me just recharge. Let's try again. Let's see if there's an issue with our app now. You can see that's working. We can go here. The merge conflicts is not working. Okay, maybe this is just for representation. Okay, there's nothing more, but I cannot see how to access the other lessons beyond this. We probably need to update this your progress component. So I will have to create a new task, but before that, let me commit our changes here. And then let's see what's inside the progress bar. It's not here. So the progress bar is shown earlier. Maybe it's not used right now. Progress. Yep, here's the progress tracker. What I will do now before we update that is I will close all of this and I will ask Cline to wire this up first. All right, looks like there's no more typing issues. All right, no TypeScript errors. Good. Looks like we're done. All right, let's see. Yeah, those are still working, but only until there. So let me ask Cline to update this progress tracker. While it's doing that, I will commit these changes. Let me go back to Cline and save it. Okay, is it done? But looks like there's some issues. It didn't check for the other tutorial content. Nice. Can you also check if it's there? Was able to deduce that it's not there. All right. Intro. No, it's not working. Why did you revert that change? So this is the first time Cline made a mistake and it looks like there's some TypeScript issues there. We didn't ask it all at once in order to make our changes more streamlined. I know there's some pros and cons there. Like right now, since we didn't ask it all at once, it missed something. But I believe that if we did ask it all at once, it surely has some more issues than what we have right now. Okay. Oh, there you go. Introduction, setting up. Okay. Looking good. You can also check to see what is this for. Okay, so I will use Cline or Aider to fix that. Now let me commit these changes. So you see, I don't need to download any project zip to make some changes, but you still see how the development workflow is being done. It's still being done by a prompt. I didn't touch any code here as if I'm not a developer. So if I can do it like this, surely you can. So I believe that it's just a matter of practicing and learning something new that might be uncomfortable at first. So let me create a new task here just to get it out of the way. Now I will ask Aider to check what is this for.
And that wraps up part two. We have successfully transitioned our project to Cursor IDE and Cline, allowing us to make more intricate changes and gain full control over our app. In the next and final part, we'll bring everything together with precise, detail-oriented edits using Aider, and then we'll deploy our app to make it live. Stay tuned for the finishing touches that will complete our project. Thanks for watching. Happy coding!